have this real simple MP3 recorder. It's an Olympus. And if you want to know how to make super fast progress, great progress in clarity, I've been using this to do so. And since I drive, spend a lot of most of my day driving, I just put this, wedge this between the sun visor and the top of the roof, inner roof of the car, and I guess you call it the ceiling, and just hit the record button, boom, right here, just one button, you know, record, boom, wedge it up there, and then start talking as if I were doing a taping. And what that does, it forces me to concentrate, to think, and instead of just letting the mind wander, listening to music, looking, just you're trying to bring forward the best clarity possible. And I have many trips that they go like 20 minutes, 15, half an hour, 45 minutes, another 20, another 30. And so each time between those trips, I've just recorded, just make a recording on this MP3 recorder. It just takes one AAA battery. And in so doing, I have found just an astonishing breakthrough. I've made more progress in the last couple days than I can even explain. It's been truly the most ever. It's just astonishing what's happening. The breakthroughs, just incredible breakthroughs by doing this. So, also this taping, I've been doing videotaping for a long time, actually. I don't even remember when I started. I remember buying an old, one of the first video cameras that I taped to a VHS tape from the video camera on an RCA cable. And so I don't know how long I've been doing it. Maybe 20 years, 25 years or something. Taping. Again, I used to do a daily taping every morning. After reading A Course in Miracles, I would study A Course in Miracles, and then I would give do a taping and try to clarify as best I could. And I did hundreds and hundreds of hours of taping that way. Eventually, I threw all that tape away, but you know, I've been doing it for a long time. So that causes and enables you to try and get your thoughts clear, your thinking clear. You have to try and bring something profound to the front, okay? This is not gossip, it's not jokes, it's something, you're trying to find something truly profound. Bring it to the front and then share it, express it and share it. And that puts tremendous discipline on you and enables you to make breakthroughs that otherwise just wouldn't come at all. It's a very different thing than just reading a book, very different. Because in order to say something, you have to see it. In order to really talk about it, say something, you need to see it. You need to really have a sense of it, really get a feel of it, and see it, and say, ah, okay, now I can really, you know, share this. So these disciplines, along with trying to make videos of all different types, informative videos, it really causes one to focus, and great discipline. So I highly recommend whatever you have. If you have like a dumb phone, you could turn into a smartphone by taping wherever you are. Sit down and take 20 minutes. Or you know, you're riding a bus and maybe you know you have a little just talking, do a little taping. I don't know if they have MP3 recorders on some dumb phones or not, but turn your dumb phone into a smartphone somehow by doing taping like this, and tape as if you're sharing it with the world, with very intelligent people. And you have to really bring something of profundity to the front. And so recently I've been taping. I don't know how many tapes I made today. Every day I probably make at least 10 to 15 tapes a day on this recorder. And just every time I start driving, then I turn it on and say, okay. And I got to, you know, let me try and come up with something. And it's rough, it's ragged, but what happens is you keep trying and trying, and suddenly there's a breakthrough. And the breakthrough is astonishing, really astonishing. I've been astonished the last couple days about the progress. beyond anything that anyone would believe, actually. Really, I can hardly believe it myself. But that shows you what real dedicated effort will do, and you can do it. You this, I don't know how much this cost, but maybe $50 or $60, whatever it is. It's under $100 for sure. It's just a very cheap little MP3 recorder. It's just a little, you can look it up online, Google Olympus imaging, I don't know. It doesn't even have, oh, digital voice recorder, WS-802. Digital voice recorder, WS-802. Great, 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 great little gadget. See, you can use gadgets in the right way, which is what I've always tried to do. I'm not a Luddite, you know, what I say is, or an Amish, I say is, make right use of the whatever expedience you have, make right use of them. Wherever you are, if I was on a desert island, I would find a way to come up with some very, very helpful expedient with the help of the Holy Spirit. Would somehow, I would, you know. So wherever you are, use what you have. Now the funny thing is that it took me 10 years before I started using this. It's crazy, stupid waste of time. But it's better late is better than never. Better late than never, and most people never do it. So what I find is the arrogance that we have is so strong that it's very difficult for us to practice or do anything that's helpful. Very difficult. But if you ever do get to that point where you actually do practice, and then you'll find your progress will be astonishing to you. I'm in awe of the insights I had today, right now. I'm fine, but part of me is in awe, just to say, my gosh, that is just like, I've never heard of such a thing. The way that I'm able to see the situation now is completely turned around and different than what one would expect. So the important thing is to keep practicing. Whatever you're saying, don't worry, the wise will not hold you to what you say. Because they know you're trying to learn to walk. You know, of course, when you try to walk, you may be crawling and then getting up and stumbling and falling. And of course, that's expected. So you should try. It's the effort that's important. The will to do it. The will to clarify. Keep strengthening the will to clarify. And practice. And even if you can't practice, keep in your mind, keep saying, "Wow, I really should practice." Because I've had this recorder and others, I just never could figure out how to use it. Now, wedging it up above that sun visor, it's right above my head and I can talk. It goes right into it. You know, no hands, I'm not involved with touching anything when I'm driving. Before I leave a place, I'll just turn it on, and then when I get to the next place and stop, I'll turn it off. Something else, it's very simple. It's like answering pushing a Bluetooth device or something on or something like that. It's legal. It's no problem. It doesn't interfere with driving at all. So it's getting to that point where you actually practice. I know from experience it's super difficult. I'm just glad that I didn't spend my entire life resisting it. Same thing with the Course in Miracles. It says, look, just do the exercises, even though you don't understand, and which I didn't, just do them. And somehow it brings a discipline to your spiritual path. I mean, really, I did 365 exercises, one a day, and I didn't understand what the heck they were talking about. And it says, well, you know, even though you don't realize the helpfulness, it's still there. So maybe that's true, because I still don't understand it, but I have had these breakthroughs, which for me are better, way better. It's just amazing. So those exercises, no doubt, somehow instill this discipline every day. You know, every day you've got to make a full-on effort. There's nothing better than that. So don't worry about the results right now. Don't worry about results. Worry about the effort. And you'd be surprised. When you make an effort, suddenly things will click and click dots, and you say, whoa, I got it. You know, I got somewhere. I see something I didn't see before. That's amazing. I didn't think I would. But today was off the charts. I say, August is, what is August going to be? Off the charts, maybe, really. Assuming, this will go forward. I will continue to work, and the insights will continue to come. I mean, it's just no two ways about it. Every time I make an effort, there is a breakthrough every time. So it's just truly amazing. And we need those breakthroughs right now. We really are in that time. So just watching these videos, it is a discipline, is an effort. So that's why I make the videos longer, because it is the effort that's important. Just like an exercise program. You know, if you just do it and do it and do it and do it, after a while, you say, wow, I'm in pretty good shape. And it didn't come just easily. It came because you kept at it. So just the capacity to consider viewing a different perspective, really a really different perspective, is super helpful, because what I've seen in the breakthroughs is the turnaround is breathtaking. I mean, the breakthroughs are such a new perspective that I just like, wow, breathtaking. Because I'd never thought of that. I'd never even thought of that. How amazing. The whole situation is becoming very amazing right now. And I don't know what's next, but I can say the last 2 days have been off the charts amazing. Unexpected. The insights, I never even thought of looking at this things this way, situation this way. Never. And I never heard it ever written anywhere. Never come across it or anything, and just the way of looking at it now is just like opening up just an incredible door to freedom so easy. All of that predicated, looking back, predicated on just the work, continuous work, try to make breakthroughs, keep at it, use the expedience, always be involved in some project, something that is trying to bring clarity to everyone. Trying to bring clarity to yourself, trying to see the way home, you know, trying to clarify the way home. What is really the way? And that is the difference. It's the ones who put the effort in. Those are the ones that someday will have the breakthroughs and say, wow, I finally got it. Even no matter how much success you have, next day is right back. Keep on working. It's like tonight, I had all the success today. Had dinner, had a little break, watched the Giants lose again, and then said, okay, back to the effort here. Come on. Even though I'm tired, you can do it. You can at least make an effort. So even if you feel tired, listless, sluggish, still try, and it may be hard to get your engine going, but you can do it. Now the breakthroughs, I can use words to explain it, but it really is based on a very clear context in order to reach this. So if I say what it is, it most likely you'll get put into the wrong context, and then you'll feel all unstable is the problem. But I will say this, I will talk in a general way. This is just an incredible insight, that the fact is that the Holy Spirit is a new creation of God, and it's our companion forever now. We'll always remain with reality. So it's like we have a new sibling, and our real responsibility now is to meet and get acquainted with the Holy Spirit. That is actually what we need to do, is get acquainted with the Holy Spirit. Because it's going to be our companion forever. It's there forever now. And so just like, let's say you're a family and your parents have another child, you know, have a sibling. Well, you're going to get used to that sibling and find out what they're like, and appreciate them, and you know, you don't just ignore them. So, actually, our focus needs to be on getting acquainted with the Holy Spirit. We don't know what the Holy Spirit's like. We don't know, because we've been so wrapped up in our effort to die that we're not even made any attempt to get to know the Holy Spirit. A fellow, you know, creation of God, an amazing, amazing, amazing sibling we have, as it were, companion through eternity now. And so our real focus on salvation is to get acquainted with the Holy Spirit. And in doing so, the fact is the Holy Spirit that solves the continuity problem for us by us getting acquainted with the Holy Spirit. That is how we solve the continuity problem, how it gets solved for us. Because what we do is we say, Holy Spirit, how do you see the world? How do you see the world? I want to get acquainted with you. I need to know, how do you see the world? What's your view of the world? And then the Holy Spirit will show us, say, okay, here's how I see the world. And it will provide us with the perceptual means to see, to view how it views the world. And what we're told is, the way the Holy Spirit views the world and the universe is so lovely, so incredibly beautiful and lovely, that in itself melts the continuity problem away for us. So think of the Holy Spirit as your little sibling. And you just say, hey, you know, okay, it talks, it can talk now, and you say, how do you see the world? You know, what how do you view everything? What's your viewpoint? And the sibling says, oh, okay, I'll share my viewpoint with you. And you say, okay, I'm all eyes and ears. I will just, you know, I want to see how you see things. And in doing so, we will be saved from the continuity problem. That's amazing. Now, there are other things I could say, but it'll get a little more complicated. So let's keep it simple at this point. That all we have to do is in our hearts say, you know, Holy Spirit, I'm not going to try and reject you and say, no, I'm the only son and I don't want you in reality. I don't need you and all this stuff. Say, hey, turn it around and say, I'm just thrilled that God has created, made this creation, and I know it must be something tremendously wonderful. So I'm absolutely eager to get acquainted with you. And what are you like? I don't know, but I want to find out. So you just ask the Holy Spirit. You say, I'm willing to find out, get acquainted, and see how you see things. I want to see through your eyes. How does everything look through your eyes, not through mine? See, give up your concern with your personal enlightenment, like I need to be enlightened. Forget about enlightenment. Instead, say to the Holy Spirit, you know what? I'm willing to see the world through your eyes. How do you see the world? Because remember, the Holy Spirit was specifically created by the Prime Creator to resolve our continuity problem and to see things for us. Okay, our continuity problem is the way we see things, we're afraid to drop it. We cannot get out of it. But the Holy Spirit sees things for us. So we're still seeing things, but through its eyes, which were specifically, through its perception, specifically designed to resolve the continuity issue for us effortlessly. So all we need to do is just, you know, view through the Holy Spirit's perception. View everything through the Holy Spirit's perception. Very simple. None of us need to be enlightened. Forget about enlightenment. Enlightenment's of the ego, actually. The ego promotes enlightenment. It's to keep us away from viewing the world through the Holy Spirit's perception. That is a fact. That's what I realized today, too. It's like, wow. Yeah, the ego will do anything to distract us away from simply perceiving as the Holy Spirit does, using the Holy Spirit's perception. How does the Holy Spirit see everything? And so it tells us, hey, there's this path to enlightenment. You can be enlightened. You can be enlightened. The fact is, we can never be enlightened because we're spirit. We're being enlightened. It's the Holy Spirit that's enlightened, really. And we're just viewing its enlightenment. Okay, it's different. It's not our enlightenment. It's the Holy Spirit's enlightenment. The Holy Spirit was created enlightened, meaning able to solve the continuity problem. All time, all space, all things. The way it perceives it does not cause it any continuity problem, okay? So if we view everything the way the Holy Spirit views it, our continuity problem is solved. That's different than enlightenment. We don't need enlightenment. We need the continuity problem solved. The Holy Spirit is enlightened. So we're viewing its enlightenment, okay? Very different turnaround, right? So nobody's ever been enlightened. Nobody ever will be enlightened, and nobody needs to be enlightened. The Holy Spirit is enlightened. And all we need to do is view its enlightenment. That's it. Now this just totally changes the whole picture, really. when you see this, it's just like, whoa. But I recognize it, like, wow, this is true. This is really true. And that's why those who claim to be enlightened, I always say, you know, something is just, it's not quite it for some reason, you know. Because it's the ego that is talking about personal enlightenment. You're reaching a state of enlightenment. No. That doesn't solve the continuity problem. Perceive the Holy Spirit's enlightenment. That's all we need to do. And the Holy Spirit provides the means of perception, which is all important. The Holy Spirit will provide the means of perceiving its enlightenment. So this whole thing just clicked into place, and it fits like a glove. It fits perfectly. And I just said, you know, wow, what a perfect fit. Now, in A Course in Miracles, Jesus says, follow your joy. What should I do? Or maybe in the other voice by Dr. Brent Haskell. What should I do with my life? He says, follow your joy. Well, my joy is to perceive as the Holy Spirit perceives things. Perceive the Holy Spirit's enlightenment. See through the eyes of the Holy Spirit. That is my joy. See, that's what I want to do. So, and I am following my joy in that regard. So all of this has a feeling of incredible profundity, actually. And it seems to just sweep aside everything else is just irrelevant now at this point. I don't need enlightenment. Nobody needs enlightenment. We just need to see what the Holy Spirit is seeing. See through the Holy Spirit's eyes, as it were. Share in its perception. We simply need to share in the perception of the Holy Spirit. How is the Holy Spirit perceiving time, space, things, events in time, space? Okay, how is it perceiving these? And we are told that this perception, again, is just beyond lovely. You know, it's just incredible. It's like watching an incredible movie. That's all I need to do. We just need to watch this movie. We just passively watch this movie and just say, wow, that is incredible, wonderful. So this is the incredibly simple message of salvation. And yet it seems to be incredibly difficult to get to this. I don't, you know why it was so difficult to see this, but it has been because of our arrogance and because of fear of the continuity issue. We keep hedging our bets, hedging and keep being vulnerable to the ego, and the ego just keeps feeding us distraction after distraction after distraction. It says, do this. No, you don't need to do that. Look at this beautiful person. See, you don't need to see the Holy Spirit's the way the Holy Spirit sees the world. Look at this beautiful sunset. Or you can see something beautiful with your own eyes. You don't need to see the world the way the Holy Spirit sees it. Look at all this beauty there is. You know, so the ego keeps distracting us, and trying to turn us away. So that's why it's so difficult. The ego will say, hey, you know, you don't need to see the world the way the Holy Spirit sees it. You can be enlightened. We say, oh, really? Yeah. You can be enlightened, whatever that is. And we think, oh. In other words, the ego says, you don't need it. You don't need this special creation of God. You don't need it. You don't even need God. You can be the author of your own salvation. But certainly the ego says that you don't need the Holy Spirit. I'll tell you what the Holy Spirit has for you. I'll share what it has with you. The ego pretends that it knows, that it's seeing what the Holy Spirit sees, and it can share it with you. And it says, yeah, look at this beautiful landscape, this sunset or the flower or something, you know. And so, of course, we're caught in that like a web, like a spider web, and it's very difficult to get out. But you can, by looking at these, what you do, have an awareness, like you do something, you look at it and say, wait a minute, that this wasn't quite right. You can gradually get a perspective on it. That the ego is desperately trying to offer any alternative, anything but looking at the world as the Holy Spirit sees it. Anything but that. People offer you anything but that. But the trouble is, only that resolves the continuity issue for us. So all this other stuff, you don't get anywhere. You just waste your time, really. And yet the ego tells you you should be proud. You say, wow, what a great job. What a great job. In other words, you wasted another life. What a great job you've done. It pats you on the back. As if you've been listening to its sage advice, as if you know, it's a great thing. It's not. It's a waste of time. So nothing has happened, you know, yet with me. Everything's still the same. So, you know, it's fine. The progress is fine. It hasn't caused any troubles. But it's a tremendous discipline because you can see your mind fighting against it. Most definitely, and especially when the mind tries to say, okay, let's define your progress. Let's quantify your progress. You feel it coming to a screeching halt. You have to go, whoa, no. Just keep going forward. Forget about the progress. Just keep going forward. Just keep, you know, keep the momentum going. Keep the momentum going. Don't try to define, quantify, anything like that. So these videos here are the result of a day of effort. It's a tricky thing to make videos, actually, because you can delay yourself in doing so. So I have to be very aware of this feeling of you know, slowing down and delaying. I have to avoid it. So that's why I check in with myself and say, you know, how do I feel about this? Is it okay to share this? It won't slow me down too much. And if you keep the momentum going, you'll find you just keep going to new territory. Yeah, slack-jawed, you know, just, look at this. You say, my God, these are things that are rarely seen. I'm seeing wonderful territory here. It's got freedom stamped all over it. So then somehow you have to pick up the pace, and it's not easy. This really helps me. And the video camera, you know, in the evening, is great, great discipline. Whatever your discipline is, I used to write songs, you know, I used to do special effects. I used to do this and this, and there's always something. I used to read books. There's always some effort. I've always been doing some effort as best I could, always. So that's what's necessary, because the ego is the master of distraction. And it is got the leverage over you. It has leverage over you because of the continuity, your fear of directly jumping back to reality. It has leverage over you. And so it's always using this leverage. And so it's like it makes you uncomfortable. And you just want to say, I want to get past this, like this feeling. So it's a struggle. But most definitely there are breakthroughs. They're there. Just realize I don't have to do anything to be enlightened. I don't even have to be enlightened at all. That's just all that stuff is just the ego. All I have to do is see the world as the Holy Spirit sees it. And that's my responsibility. And that's what I want to do because the Holy Spirit is our new sibling. You know, so let's welcome it. You know, instead of being fearful, let's say, oh my gosh, I'm so grateful that you're here. Just welcome, welcome, welcome. I want to welcome you because we're the older siblings, as it were. So we need to go to the Holy Spirit and say, oh my gosh, I'm so glad you're here. I'm just thrilled. And open up your heart that way, as it were. And it gives you a completely different orientation. That's what I found out. It changes the whole tenor of the spiritual path entirely. Just gone is all this other stuff. It's just as if it never was. I mean, just like, it's just irrelevant. And the ego is so clever. It says, hey, you don't need the Holy Spirit. What about this guru, you know? Be happy to see this guru. Anything but the Holy Spirit, you see. It will say, worship this guru, worship this, worship that, do that. Oh, you'd be so wonderful. You know, why don't you greet this guru? No, the guru is not the Holy Spirit. There's no one that's the Holy Spirit. Only the Holy Spirit is the Holy Spirit. The Holy Spirit, it doesn't have a form. It's formless. But it does have a perception of everything. Does have a perception, does have a stand viewpoint of that, and that can be seen. It can share that with you. Just let's take it that the Holy Spirit, like, is in your house, dwells in your house, and it's in a room, it's off to the side, and you've just ignored it for so long, just completely ignored it, like it doesn't exist. But then one day you just say, wow, you realize, wait a minute, you know, why have I been ignoring the Holy Spirit? This is my sibling. This is one with me now. This is a creation of the Prime Creator. This has equal standing with me, and it will be with me and reality forever. And my gosh, refusal to acknowledge the Holy Spirit refuses refusal not to acknowledge myself. And it'll start to dawn on you that this neglect, that you've been neglecting it and refusing to welcome it. And then your heart will change. You'll say, wow, that's really arrogant to just, you know, reject it like that. And then you start saying, hey, maybe I can change my perspective on this. And then it starts changing. It's changing, changing. And you start to see, oh, this is a very happy. And you start to acknowledge the Holy Spirit. Very happy. Very happy you're here. Very happy you're here in this house with me. And I'm just thrilled. And I accept your invitation to get acquainted. I accept, you know. And just start telling yourself that, hey, I accept the invitation. And you'll find that all your spiritual concerns suddenly seem distant because you hit upon the central answer. And you start to have a relationship. You feel that there's going to be a relationship now with the Holy Spirit because that is what the Holy Spirit is, one with reality, as you are now. It's a new creation, and you get to enjoy this. So it augments your own experiencing. So it's a tremendous benefit, tremendous, wonderful, wonderful grace. And you say, I can have a relationship with the Holy Spirit. It's my sibling. I can get to know the Holy Spirit and what it has to offer. And so that changes everything. And you say, all right, I'm into that. I'm into that. And then all this other stuff, it's like it suddenly seems completely distant. Bug. All this other stuff completely distant. Then you realize this is not necessary. Because all I need to do is get acquainted with the Holy Spirit. Start to have a relationship with the Holy Spirit. And just ask the Holy Spirit, how do you see everything? How do you see things? I'd like to know. I'd like to know. I want to experience how do you see things so I can know what you're like. And then the Holy Spirit will say, of course, here. I'll share that with you. I have the capability to do that. And you say, wow, that's great. You're very useful. Very useful, the Holy Spirit. More useful than we realize. More helpful than we realize. And finding this out is again, it lifts your entire being up, as it were, out of other concerns. And you realize that it's just that you've been neglecting this, is all. You've just been rejecting, denying, neglecting the Holy Spirit, just neglecting it, as if hoping it would go away. If you just paid no attention to it, you hoped it would go away. But it just sat there in a corner, you know, just quiet, just sat there. Like, wow. And just be honest and tell the Holy Spirit, hey, I've been neglecting you. I hope that you would just go away. And now I see, you know, the mistake, the error of my ways. You know, I'm grateful that you helped, gave me the time to sort this out and realize, wow, what a mistake. So these are the incredible, you know, insights that have been coming that I've never even thought about before, like this. No. And right on time, because we have some troubles coming, for sure, in the world. We have troubles coming, as expected, because, of course, the ego is hell-bent on teaching us how to die. And we're hell-bent on it. Spirit is intrigued by it. What is death? What is this? You know, some special power. God can't die. God, there's no death in reality. So what is this death thing? How can I learn that? So we're desperately trying to learn how to die. And of course, the cosmos accommodates us 100% because it's the training program for that. So of course, death is always right at our heels, actually. And who's to say it won't be coming in unusual ways, as a matter of fact. And it most certainly will. So, but the Holy Spirit doesn't wish death on us at all. It is life. You know? So, and here's another thing. We'll ask the Holy Spirit. We'll say, Holy Spirit, where do you like to dwell? I mean, what's your dwelling place in terms of how do you see your home? Can you show me how you view your home? You know, how do you view home? And the Holy Spirit will say, sure. And we could very well find ourselves in an incredibly beautiful place. I say, wow, this is a way that the Holy Spirit sees in time and space and things, something that it, how do you symbolize home, Holy Spirit? And then it will show us. And we can dwell there. So can I, you mind if I dwell there with you in this same perception of home? And the Holy Spirit say, of course, let's get acquainted. Please do, you know. So where's the danger there? Where's the death there? No, it's not there. So your safety is actually, getting acquainted with the Holy Spirit is safety itself. So yeah, my perspective has completely changed now. I mean, like if Jesus came back, I would just say, sit down here and let's just sit together. And let's just help me focus on getting acquainted with the Holy Spirit. That's all. Same with Ananda Mahima or any other guru. I just would sit, and my focus wouldn't be on them. It would, you know, sit together and let's together help me, not on one another. Because we need the continuity problem solved before we can truly feel one with one another, as the feel the oneness that we all are. And we have this new creation, and we need to find out all about it and learn how to be one, how to accept the oneness with this Holy Spirit now, and its blessing that it has for us. We need to get acquainted with it. So at this point, I don't even feel like if Jesus walked up to me right now, I don't even feel it would knock me off track or anything. I probably wouldn't even ask him anything or say anything. I'd say, please sit down. You're very welcome here. And that's probably about it. Because my focus would be on the Holy Spirit saying, I'm accepting your invitation, Holy Spirit. I'm accepting your invitation to see as you see, to experience how you see things. How do you see things? I'm willing to see how you see things so I can get acquainted with you. That's my focus. That's it. That's all that's needed. So there really is no, among us, there's no status games, things going, there's nothing going on really. It's just because we're focused on getting acquainted with the Holy Spirit. So we're not into each other. What do you know? You know, questioning, what do you know? Forget it. It doesn't matter what you know. It matters I want to get acquainted with the Holy Spirit. That's what matters. I mean, you want to get acquainted with the Holy Spirit. That's all that matters. It's not what we know. Who cares what we know? It's seeing the world as the Holy Spirit sees it. That is the important issue. That is what we need. That is the experience that we need. I hope the mosquitoes aren't getting me. So, this is just a complete, wonderful change in perspective. And we need it. We absolutely need it. This is a game changer. It's a total game changer. And we need that game changer because I believe that sooner or later, probably sooner, some big game changer is going to show up in the world. A lot of game changers are showing up, actually. But so the cumulative effect of them, cumulative effect, who knows? Who knows? Yeah. There's a lot that could happen, actually. But all of that really doesn't matter. Because if your focus is on, I am going to get acquainted with the Holy Spirit, period. I don't care what happens. I am going to do this. You're in a different mental state. You're in a different state. And that's the state I'm in right now. It's a different state of mind. Different state of mind. So, come hell or high water, you know, I'm not going to change my objective. My objective is very clear. And it's that determination, probably, I would say, just the very fact that I've accepted the offer, I agree, you know, I'm in on that. The Holy Spirit will certainly might say, okay, let's go somewhere where we can get acquainted, because this place is, you know, it's going to be very problematical. You know, that's a possibility. I don't know. But certainly, I believe the Holy Spirit will certainly honor, you know, that request. Honor it. Absolutely. It wants to get acquainted with us too. You know, it really does. It really is just waiting for us to acknowledge it and say, hey, it's time for us to get acquainted. Yeah, I really want to. I'm looking forward to it. I'm very eager. with greatest of faith and positive, you know, perspective on it. Because it's just tremendous opportunity here. And so it will somehow honor that, you know. Absolutely, that's how I feel. So I expect my future to become, you know, really blessed now. Really blessed. How that plays out, I really don't know. I really don't know. I just have to take it one step at a time. One step at a time. So anyway, I'm happy to share all this with those who are willing to view this. It's an extraordinary thing to even view this because it's so different. The approach is so different. Yet somewhere inside you, maybe there's like reverberation going on. It's like, whoa, I forgot about this. This is what I forgot about. And it is. It's what I forgot about. You know, this is what I forgot about. The world makes you forget. The world makes you chase after enlightenment. You know, and it's like, wow, I came into this world and everybody said, oh, you're really spiritual. I said, yeah. He said, great. Maybe you could be enlightened. You know, that'd be incredible if you could be enlightened. And, oh, yeah, you should really pursue this enlightenment and stuff. Maybe you could be a guru or something, master. And you get knocked off track by that. You get knocked off track entirely. It was just terrible. They always said, no, you're missing it. You're missing it. Something, you're missing it. But it's so strong here that you just feel like you get, you know, pushed and pushed and pushed and pushed. So finally I'm remembering why I came here, you know, and the right focus. You know, forget about being a master or a guru or enlightened and all that stuff. That's all nonsense. Just nonsense. Get acquainted with the Holy Spirit and then see how you feel about it. How you feel about everything. Totally different story. You will be perceiving this loveliness beyond any explanation. You know, you just simply see just glorious, you know, loveliness and beauty and peace and harmony and everything. Just you'll be just perceiving it. You'll be seeing it. You don't need to, you know. You're just seeing it, and it's the Holy Spirit that's showing it to you. So you're not thinking I'm a master or a guru or a teacher or a sage or a saint or anything like that. It's ridiculous. You're just a friend of the Holy Spirit. You're a sibling of the Holy Spirit. You're just getting acquainted with the Holy Spirit. That's all you're doing. That's it. It's just being given to you. It's just being given to you. Just because you're willing to. That's all. And everybody else could have exactly the same experience, you know. When they're willing to get acquainted, though, they too will have this. So it's just there's no need to think about status or anything, really. That's if there's any pragmatic application of that, it will be applied, but really that's the farthest thing from my mind. That's the ego that tries to apply all those labels and stuff. That's why the great gurus say that they're not gurus. I'm not a guru. I'm nobody's guru. I just see God. I'm just seeing God. That's all. I'm nobody's guru. I'm not a guru. I'm just seeing God. What else is there? There's nothing else. You know, I'm just perceiving everything through the eyes of the Holy Spirit. And that's all. And you can do so also. That's it. We're all one. But just stop neglecting this. Stop neglecting it. In arrogance, we say, no, we can be prime creators. As soon as we learn how to die, we'll become prime creator. And so we're neglecting the Holy Spirit. But it's there. It's there. It's there for everybody. All right. So this is it. This is tremendous. It's a great way to prepare for August. And what is August again? What is August? Whew, my gosh, what is August? Breakthroughs. Success. By the way, comet Zion, Ison, is on, noise, comet, all that, the name is incredible. It's going to be first viewed in August, maybe around my birthday, actually. We'll start to pick it up with telescopes from Earth. How about that? So I would say that about the time we're picking up Zion from Earth, we should, that those who really want to be saved should begin to perceive the world and the universe through the eyes of the Holy Spirit, through the perception of the Holy Spirit. Perceive it as the Holy Spirit is perceiving it. Should begin to do that. That's the breakthrough that's needed. Otherwise, you're going to get your attention riveted on this comet, which is not good. You're not supposed to have your attention riveted. I'm talking about it, but only as a warning so that you don't get your attention caught on it. That there's got to be something else better than the comet coming in. Because once it starts being seen here on the Earth, I'm telling you, the world is going to get obsessed with it. And that's along with everything else that's going to be happening. You don't want to be obsessed with it. You want to begin to experience a relationship, to get acquainted with the Holy Spirit, begin to experience a relationship with the Holy Spirit and how the Holy Spirit perceives everything. That's what you want by that time. So I would say August is the month for that. No question, it is the month for that. Now, there may be those who actually begin this acquaintance, begin to see as the Holy Spirit sees. Great. And those who haven't quite gotten there and are still a little reluctant, they can at least begin to focus on that and say, this is what I want. Okay, this is more important than Ison coming in, Comet Zion. This is more important. This is way, way more important. All this other stuff. Transmutation, blah, 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 you know, whatever. That's not important. What's important is beginning to get acquainted with the Holy Spirit. That's what's important. Begin to strike up a friendship. Begin to acknowledge it. Say, hey, I'm glad you're here. It's time for us to get acquainted, you know, and let's do it right now. And that will, you'll realize that is way more profound than Ison, Zion Comet. The Zion Comet. But as it gets brighter and brighter and brighter and brighter and comes in, and then as it's, you know, going around the sun, people will just be like transfixed by what's going to happen, what's going to happen. And as it comes, you know, around the sun and now visible to us in January, it becomes super bright. If that's what happens, people will just say, ah, you know, it's like it'll be, the whole world will be caught up in it, you know, really. The world mania is coming. And if it breaks up, then people will just be like freaking out, you know. And if it comes in and hits the earth, various chunks of it hit the earth, you know, then that's curtains. So it's very important now, do not get caught up in the mania. So we're vetting it ahead of time. So we say, yeah, I know what's going on. It's going about 57,000 miles per hour. Once it goes around the sun, it'll be going maybe around 420,000 miles an hour. How about that? Speed of 420,000 miles an hour. And et cetera, et cetera, et cetera. It's giving off a lot of, what, carbon dioxide, a lot of gas. Ice is heating up. It's giving out a lot of dust. It's losing mass and blah, blah, blah. And so we realize that the foreshadowing that's taking place right now is very ominous foreshadowing. We realize that. We realize that the world is collapsing. It's going in the wrong direction, going in the direction of works, the egoic direction. It's going in the egoic direction right now. The wolf is in charge of the hen house now. You know, wolf in sheep's clothing is in charge of the hen house. The good shepherd is the wolf now, instead of the good shepherd. You know, the whole idea of shepherding a flock is you protect it from the inimical, the foxes, the wolves, the predators that want to harm the flock. And now the flock has been opened, the hen house has been opened up, and all the predators invited in. Come on in, come on in, come on in. We're tolerant. Let's be very tolerant here. So, and what I mean by that is those who want to, who say, we have an alternative to getting acquainted with the Holy Spirit. Let's get into each other, get into the flesh, get into how cool we are and stuff, you know, that kind of stuff. Those are the wolves. Okay, those are the wolves. We are the sheep. And the sheep, we just want to welcome the Holy Spirit into our family. With love, and just I'm so happy you're here. Just absolutely overwhelmed with joy that you're here. That's the real child. That's the divine child that we're welcoming, is the Holy Spirit. Because when we decided to be prime creator, or try to be prime creator, there was no Holy Spirit. There was no Holy Spirit. The Holy Spirit was a special creation by the prime creator to resolve the continuity problem for us. So we don't know the Holy Spirit. Before, when we fell into a deep sleep, there was no Holy Spirit. So this is something new for us, you know, and we need to say, wow, how fantastic, and get to know it, get to know it. See through its eyes. Find out how it views things. Find out its viewpoint, and we will be amazed. Just say, wow, that is incredible. That's better than a comet. All right, so if you're up to speed, and some of you are kind of, you know, going along, getting pretty much up to speed, you're in a great place, a great place. August, breakthrough, success, beginning of a relationship with the Holy Spirit, and something that's better than Ison, okay? Better than Comet Zion, and it's breakneck speed, going around the sun at 420,000 miles an hour. Like a train going around a turn too fast, right? Getting derailed. Who's to say? And why do we want to follow that story? We don't. We don't want to follow that story. What is that? That's boring. Disaster is boring. It's really boring. It's like, what else is new? You know, another train went off the tracks. You know, yeah. Death is boring. All this trying to learn how to die is very boring. Holy Spirit's not boring. We have this new sibling. Yes, that's not boring. That is not boring. Wow. It's different than us. Let's find out, you know, what's his perspective? You know, what does it have to offer? Let's find out. Not secondhand through the ego. The ego will always tell us it knows and share it with us. Not secondhand. I mean, if you're married and someone says, well, you don't need to live with your spouse. Well, I'll explain to you what the spouse is like, and you know, what are your friend, your best friend? They say you don't need to be with your best friend or ever talk to them. I'll pass on to you what they're saying to you, and then you say to them, and I'll pass it back on to them. I'll be an intermediary, and you don't ever have to have anything to do with them. What is that? What is that? You're not getting to know them. You're not experiencing them. You're not seeing. And the ego says, well, I'll tell you how the Holy Spirit sees all these things. I'll show you. I'll tell you how it is. It's kind of like, you know, this sunset or these flowers. Just focus on that, and that's enough for you. No, that's not actually accepting the perception, the means of perception the Holy Spirit has for us, giving, showing us directly what it's seeing. It's sharing it directly with us. That's not sharing it at all. That's completely avoiding it. So the ego will give us all this stuff to help us avoid it, and say, well, this is it. I'm sure. I know what the Holy Spirit's like. Really? No, it doesn't. It knows that as soon as we strike up an acquaintance with the Holy Spirit, ego's finished. It's finished. So it is incredibly desperate to avoid that. Therefore, that's why you have the troubles to get to that. The great obfuscator, the ego, the great delayer. It's the great delayer. But if you keep on hammering away at the ego and keep taping and say, you know what, I'm going to get past this delay. What's that? You will find that you can do it. You can do it. You can do it. It's within you. For sure, it's within you. Because the Holy Spirit's there with you. All you have to do is keep asking. Hey, I'd like to get acquainted, but I'm jittery. Can you help me? And it will somehow help you. It will help you. It understands that you're jittery, and it knows that you're got this continuity issue, and you're all freaked out. So it's very patient. It knows. You know, it'll just help you out, but you have to, you know, put in the effort. Keep putting in the effort. And let's be prepared in advance for this Zion Ison mania. Ice on. There's another thing. Ice on. Is on or ice on? The ice is on. You know, What is that about? This name, Aizan. It's got everything bad in the world. Bad there is, doesn't it? The Blue Kachina is here. These are the Hopi prophecies are being fulfilled. This is the 2013, December 21st, 2013. It's the end of the world. Here it comes. You know, But we don't have to get caught up in that mania. We really don't. So no doubt, I'm putting the pedal to the metal. And so that we can truly have something better than that to focus on. And we will. We will. Holy Spirit's timing is impeccable. So, looking forward to, I will find out when the comet will be visible by telescope from Earth sometime in August. That's coming up, maybe it could be 3 weeks from now, as a matter of fact. Could be a matter of just 3 weeks from now, that's how close. And yet, I'm very close to breakthrough, you know, more and more breakthroughs, very, very close. So, I think it's all going to come down perfectly, and we'll have a choice. Do we obsess about Aizan, or do we decide, you know what, I'm going to start experiencing how the Holy Spirit sees everything. I'm going to get into that. I'm going to go in that direction. Simple choice. So that's a great time for us. So don't be afraid. Be inspired. Feel, you know what, we're going to succeed. August is the month that we're going to succeed at this. Plain and simple. All right. That's it.